In today's video, I'm going to show you how to stain poplar to look like this. The first step is surface prep. If you skip this part or do a poor job of sanding the surface, the stain will only magnify the mill marks and it's going to be ugly. So to begin, I started sanding with 80 grit, 120 grit, and then stopped at 150 grit. The finer grit you sand to, the more the surface is sealed and the less stain will absorb, leaving you with a lighter color. Don't forget to sand the edges in the same grit, as well as the end grain. I'm actually taking the end grain to 220 grit, which will burnish the surface. Burnishing it with the finer sandpaper will help promote even coloring. Next, I pre-raised the grain of the board using a spray bottle filled with water. I'm pre-raising the grain because I'm using a water-based pre-stain conditioner. The goal here is to get the surface wet, but not soaked. This will cause the fibers to swell and feel rough. You want to do this now instead of after you apply the pre-stain conditioner because you don't want to sand through the pre-stain conditioner to smooth the surface because you'll have to apply it again. I let the board dry overnight and the next day I very carefully sand the surface with the 150 grit on the face grain and the edge grain and the same 220 grit on the end grain to smooth the surface. To help prevent blotching like I talked about earlier, I applied a coat of a pre-stain conditioner. Wipe it all over the surface of the board including the end grain. Next, I'll follow that up by wiping the surface dry using a paper towel. I let the board dry for at least 30 minutes. Poplar has a wide variety of colors, ranging from a white to green to purple and a few others. To help even out the appearance and to set the tone of the wood, I applied an amber dye first. I apply this dye using a stain pad, wiping from edge to edge with the grain. After the whole board is covered, I then wipe off any excess with a clean paper towel. I let this coat of dye dry for 2 to 4 hours before moving on to the next step. If after the coat of dye dries you notice it's a little rough, you can take a gray or a white Scotch-Brite pad and very carefully rub the surface to remove the dust. You do not want to sand through the dye at this point, so just very, very light rubbing. The final piece of this recipe is to apply a coat of the rosewood stain. And just like before, I applied it using a stain pad. I flood the surface and then wipe off the excess using a clean paper towel. It's important to wipe away all of the excess before the stain dries or you're gonna have streaks. Give the stain at least 24 hours to dry before you apply your top coat. You can apply just about anything over the stain, but for this demo, I spray 3 coats of shellac since it dries fast. It left a gloss surface, so to cut that back to a semi-gloss, I waxed the surface using a 4-0 steel wool and a wax. If you have access to poplar, you can make it look great. With a crap load of different color stains and dyes, you can make poplar look exactly how you need it to. But keep in mind, it's not going to be perfect every single time. As you can see, even though I used a pre-stain conditioner, I still got a little blotching on the left side of the board, so keep that in mind when you're planning your project. If you have access to gel stains, you can give those a try, which would allow you to skip using the pre-stain conditioner. Since the gel stains are thicker, they don't penetrate as deeply as a dye or a stain does, so it produces an even coloring. But at the end of the day, you have to ask yourself, if you have other wood species available, is it worth paying the extra money for the finer woods, or save a little and buy a poplar, but you add the extra labor and the money of coloring the poplar to make it look like a more expensive wood? I can't answer that for you, but I can show you how to make poplar look great. Thanks for watching.